All right, so you figured out a baseline amount of calories and macronutrients that you need to go ahead to proceed to bulk. So what is that nutrition plan supposed to look like now that you have that established? Let's get right into it, shall we? Come on! I'm taking off, yes, taking off! All right, so just a quick hypothetical example of a recap regarding if somebody is trying to bulk, and I'm just putting in these random stats in, so let's go ahead and watch, okay? Let's just say he's 20 years old, you know, I don't know, okay, oops, 184 pounds, and he's 5'11", and he's pretty, you know, he's pretty damn active, 6 to 7 days a week. Okay, those are roughly about his maintenance calories according to the calculator. Again, it's not going to be exactly accurate per se, but it's a baseline to go off of. So let's go ahead and say, you know, I would recommend going off of the higher carb option because more energy, right? So let's just go ahead and say that these are his macronutrients, okay? So 279 grams of protein, 83 grams of fat, and 465 grams of carbs. What is that going to look like? Quick rundown of how macronutrients work, if you don't know. So for each gram of protein, there is 4 calories. For each gram of fat, there's 9 calories. And for each gram of carbs, there's 4 calories. So by multiplying the amount of calories for each gram, this is what it comes out to. With a total of 3,723 calories. So I compiled together a basic ass list of a select amount of foods for each macronutrient. Now, mind you, this is not going to be 100% accurate because for each food, there's going to be trace macronutrients like peanut butter. There's going to be protein in there. What I'm more so looking at is staying within the ballpark range and staying consistent with a given protocol. If you stay consistent with a given protocol, even though it's not the exact macronutrients and calories, are you losing weight or are you gaining weight or are you headed towards the right path that you want to go? And here is the given meal plan that I came up with. Now, obviously, as I've mentioned, it's not going to be the exact, and I even mention it at the bottom. Total approximates from the meal plan. So like I said, this is probably going to be more calories than what it says, 3,733, and the macronutrients are going to be a little bit different because of the trace amount of calories from the macronutrients. Now, what matters here again? Consistency. So you have that meal plan put together. And yes, it's not exactly perfect. It's not the exact because of the trace calories and macronutrients that I mentioned. You have that meal plan put together. Now what do? You stay consistent with it. And then from then on, you watch how your body responds. So now we go back to the fact that the guy is bulking. We're going back to his scenario, okay? So now that he has the meal plan put together, and despite the fact that the numbers aren't exact, he sees over a span of 2 weeks, okay? And he sees that he's gaining roughly about 1 pound a week. He sees that his strength is going up. So what does that mean? It means that the protocol is working. But the numbers aren't exact. You know, again, people will dwell so much on that, but you have that given protocol in place, in real time, in real life. You're making those foods the same way every single time. And what do you see? Progression or not? So what does he do if he's gaining weight too fast? Well, here's what he does. He pulls back from the calories, probably from the carbohydrates. He pulls back from the calories and then goes back to watching. If he's losing weight with that given approach, then he can add the calories from the protein, from the carbs, from the fats. Real life consistency and real life action is oceans and actually dimensions more important than what something says on paper. If you're doing that given protocol, are you on track? Are you on the right path or are you not? Based off of what real results are saying or the lack of. So I hope that puts things into a very easy perspective without giving you unnecessary amounts of analysis paralysis. Don't forget to check out my Linktree for coaching, ebooks, merchandise, all that good stuff. And I will be adding more to this list so I can continue to provide more value for you guys. So have a good one.